Number 7 in the Massachusetts, New England area.
Yes,
and
sir.
Oh, Lord, he coming.
So this is something Gons can go sometimes. He actually does have a pocket Game & Watch. And depending on the matchup, he likes playing as this character. And I guess against the likes of Pikachu, you know, gives him that extra little oomph from, like, the up B's potentially.
Yes, so it's very common knowledge that Palutena mains do not like to choose. The Chews are just really good at keeping a low profile, making it really hard for Palutena to generate any sort of the offense that makes you such a potent top tier. So I didn't expect Gons to start Palutena. I didn't expect him to start Game & Watch either. Because I know he's been playing Young Link a lot also, so I just can't focus on Butt Rock.
And
he was
warming up with Young Link previously too, so there was a potential he's going to do it. Now, what is this rapid jab? Why took him forever to go for that roll? I think we should ban songs with the lyrics.
You're right. Anyway, it's a good parry right there from Gons. He gets another one out of the up B. Again, Gons keeping this certainly right here. I can understand why he'd want to go to this. I think Mr. Game & Watch, like, low-key has, like, a really good matchup on Pikachu. I think that's kind of been the consensus for a while now. Like, you look at the prominent examples. I look at Meister versus E-Sam at Combo Breaker, where... Oh!
He had to. You saw DM trying to drift away from that the entire time, but managing to catch that little turtle. It's the Game & Watch. Gonna send him up flying with the up airs. DM has to get away from that. And I'm not sure if DM knows the matchup.
You think most anybody does? I mean, there was a Game & Watch main in New England by the name of Captain Q, but I don't know how prominently he plays this game.
And Gonzalez is actually pocketing those thunders. If he gets three of those suckers, that's going to be like an instant kill.
Yeah, remember when this was a thing that was banned for a while?
In doubles?
That was like OG Smash 4 stuff.
Yeah.
See ya!
There we go. Gets the grounded stay off the down smash. We're taunting out here too?
Yeah, Gons is definitely feeling himself.
Honestly... There we go. DM finally getting a punish off of there, going for the shield grab, but, you know, starting to adapt to both Gonzalez and Mr. Game & Watch bit by bit. Drags out the forward, couldn't get the final part of it, but Gons just kind of kills himself anyways. Maybe he thought he had more distance. We got that response with the triple taunt coming out from DM.
I was going to say, Game & Watch kind of thick. He did not die from that outright.
Which is weird, he's made of paper.
Yeah,
but I guess the Smash is technically 3D. You know, you see that T-pose, you got that kill off stage.
That's the funniest thing I've seen
love
in my
that
entire
image,
life. I hope we see it again someday.
If you guys want, please just go to Google and just search T-pose Game & Watch. You won't be disappointed.
It's so good.
Hey, we got the back here trying to cover those jumps out of shields.
And that up out of shield has proven to be pretty good for Mr. Game & Watch in this matchup, but here comes the pain.
The loops begin. You can't escape the pain,
God, baby.
Up B, but Mr. Game & Watch actually can. He's got that really quick jump they can do out of up B.
I feel like when Pokemon tells me that I'm paralyzed, I can't move, I'm just going to picture that from now on.
I mean, all that electricity is probably going to be a side effect. Forward throw.
Ooh.
A full bucket.
He's bursting at the seams right now.
And it lasts so long, he might be dead right here. Oh, never mind. He has the quick attack option to get back onto the stage. And he holds on to that past stocks, too.
Yeah, which is insane. Great parries right there from Gons, able to break zone to chair, extending the hit, extended hitbox to chair, buying him some time.
We're going to see the oil panic.
He's
hungry for the grab. Okay, DM still sitting at 122%. Gets the drag down there into an up smash. DM still in this fight.
It feels like he'll do it right now.
He did. No, I was feeling it too, dog. He did, but it whiffed. DM jumping above it, and now the trump card is gone, but he's still offstage at a high percent. All he needs is like one F tilt.
Or an up smash.
Yeah.
Potentially. Oh, but catches him with the back air, and it's enough.
Getting kissed by Leonardo. That's going to be game one going to Gons. Taken away pretty solidly, honestly.
Happy birthday, Sonic.
Yeah, happy birthday, Sonic. Wait, wasn't yesterday's birthday, or is it today?
No, today is his birthday.
Today's his birthday. So they had the Crush 40 concert during his birthday eve.
Yeah, I'll say this. It was fun listening to hear those songs.
Yeah.
Sung in a room full of people.
Oh, yeah.
Live and learn, all that.
I enjoyed that concert, honestly. It was a lot of fun. It was definitely a trip down memory lane.
Oh, yeah.
And then I heard a song from, like, I don't know what game it was. It was, like, Sonic Forces or Shadow the Hedgehog. I did not recognize the song whatsoever.
I think it was from Forces.
That's when
it was from Shadow the Hedgehog.
It was, like, the ending credits or something.
Yeah.
I dipped.
It was either the ending credits or the final boss theme from...
Like, I know the Shadow the Hedgehog theme. That's funny as hell. But the ending, I was like, what are these lyrics? I don't recognize them at all.
Yeah,
they had people come on stage to be like the air band, too.
He did His World. He did Open Your Heart. All Hail Shadow.
Yeah.
Banger.
His World was actually
the original.
The original was by someone else. And then Crush 40 was the third remix.
And then there was this.
And if you want more lyrics in your music.
If you guys want to hear the best, Sonic song of all time, listen to Zebrahead's cover of His World. It is so good.
And if you want more lyrics in your music, we got just the song for you, apparently.
What is this?
This is the F-Zero medley.
Oh.
Here it comes.
I think we're being told you can't listen to the lyrical music.
Oh, they got banned. There's a lot of lyrics in that song. This is a good stage. This is a good song, too.
This is fine, too.
I'm glad they're counterpicking
these. Cass's theme is one of my favorite remixes of all time.
That's why we need to see more Omegas in Battlefields, man. I love this variety of, like, environments as well as music.
This song makes you just want to dance, man.
Yeah. And also, this is, like, the biggest reason why a lot of people want stages is because they want, like, the extra music and they want the extra, the environment.
Some of these songs are great.
Yeah. And I guess they're just kind of agreeing to no platforms. It's going to be Final Destination for, like, the final set of Winner's Finals. Or, I guess, we still got a game 3
yeah, coming up.
It's best 3 of 5.
So it looks like the Game & Watch is definitely here to play right now, and DM definitely caught off guard that first game. So let's see if Gonz can continue to streak, or maybe if the gimmick will wear off. We'll see what happens first. Yeah.
And, you know, out of all of, like, the list of, like, really, like, popular top-tier characters that we see in this area, no one really expected Pikachu versus Game & Watch in Finals.
I definitely would have expected the Game & Watch. Pikachu probably not one of the ones I expected.
Oh, okay, there you go. Got the parry, down smash.
Did not get the grounding hitbox of that. That does get you stuck.
I think Dan was trying to time that up B to maybe, like, hit Gonz or just try to avoid that up B himself. Barely getting back on the ledge, goes for the invincible ledge attack there. Knock Gonz also away.
This up B's proven to be a fantastic anti-air. There we go. Kisses from Leonardo once again.
And this honestly might be why you see Gonzalez playing Game & Watch in this match. I feel like Gonz just has an answer for Quing Attack with this character. You know, that back air lasts for so long. What is going on in the background, dog? There's explosions going on.
I thought I heard a truck. Let's just go with that. It's the volcano in the back.
Definitely the volcano.
Yeah, but okay. Gonz continue to add on to this lead right now. DM just having a kind of a hard time approaching from all fronts right now. He can't really approach, you know, too far from in front of him because, you know, Gonz can do stuff like back air and forward air. And even up B's proven to be a great anti-air because he can't just quick attack above him for free.
Gets the back air, tosses him off, has the stage pressure. Trying to go for the two frame with the forward tilt, but just waits for him to let go. Shield catches the forward smash, go for a punish.
Okay. Going around right now.
Going for that down smash, trying to, you know, buy himself some time. You know, he goes for that bucket just in case DM's going to go for the thunder to be able to bucket, but catches the up smash, gets the kill. Got two stocks apiece.
Yep, a good dash attack to catch the roll behind from DM right there. You see Gonz hitting him with the chair. The wrestling show was about 2 hours ago, buddy. But
yeah.
Good job.
Already saw that. And back down and out on the ground. Just go runs across the entire stage with that dash attack, trying to pop him up in the air. And, you know, and DM's getting so much mileage out of these back airs out of shields.
Yeah, no, it's such a good shield option for Pikachu just because it comes out so fast. And even when Pikachu lands, he pancakes his own hitbox, so it's really, really hard to get a follow-up out of him. Such a good move.
And more ledge attacks coming out. Goes through the bomb. Ooh, we got Thunder dragging him down.
We got techs too, man. That was really, really good from Gonz.
And this is another tech we're seeing a lot from Gonz. He's throwing out those forward tilts constantly just in case he wants to go for another quick attack. This is a struggle bus. Forward tilt, get him off him.
Ooh, that could have been a grab right there, but Gonz just a little slow in the draw right there.
Well, Gonz thought he was going to try to cross him up with that dash attack, but I'm pretty sure it doesn't.
Did you notice that when Game & Watch throws you, you turn into your stock icon?
Mm-hmm.
That is such a good attention.
Oh, yeah. There we go. Pops him up with the quick attack. Down smash raw. I mean, honestly, that was a free punish. DM has a lead. 154%. The loops begin. But, okay, he had maximum rage on top of the Game & Watch being a light character. It's harder to connect those loops with the extra bit of knockback that you're exhibiting.
He's still continuing to fight right now, but having a hard time securing this kill.
King of Hyrule in the distance, just playing with a paraglider. What's up, dude?
Chilling. Back air, there we go. Finds his mark, so Gonz lost the lead, but is still, you know, still within
shoulders arm. Or yeah. Arms reach, excuse me.
Go another dash attack. Gets out of there.
There you go. Good use of the forward air right there for Mr. Game & Watch.
And he caught the double jump with that back air. That could have been devastating. DM still working around with these neutral airs. Catches him with the up air. Manages to whiff it. And this is just constant. DM going for quick attacks when he's like in the disadvantage. Just trying to stay away from Gaunt. He's playing the keep away game.
Yeah, for real, man. He's doing a really good job breaking zone right now. Finally able to get in with the Game Watch, and now has Gaunt in the juggle situation. Once again, getting the trade with the upbeat. That's been such a great get out of jail free card for Gaunt.
And the beautiful part about that quick attack is not only is it the get out of jail free card, if he manages to hit Gaunt with it, he can convert it. What a trade. They're both at high percent. Final stocks goes for the trade, connects it. And DM's going to put a point on the board 1-1. Going into this game three.
Okay, so I did get information from a certain man from New England whose name I will not mention right now that there are two good Game & Watches in New England that are not Captain Q anymore. Mr. Escalators and Mook are ones that come to mind. So DM is probably pretty familiar with this matchup.
Oh,
I know
yeah.
Mr. Escalator is, I think, from... I'm pretty sure he lives in the Massachusetts area where DM hails from. So shout-outs to Not Hazmat. You know, for confidentiality's sake, I will not reveal whose identity that was.
What?
I gotta go, man.
Why
is everything moving so fast?
I'm so confused what you just said, but we're gonna go into PS2. Gonzalez sticking with the Game & Watch platforms being added into the mix.
All right, home field advantage. We got more Pikachu right here. Let's see if things work out.
Okay. Gonna go for those quick attacks.
Yeah, so it looks like maybe DM is kind of caught on to what Gonz is throwing at him right now, but... Jeez, that sent him nowhere. Excuse me.
I mean, 0%. He got the parry on the quick attack, but gets the conversion off of it. Whips the up tilt. Gon's trying to stop him in his tracks. The second you get grounded, there is fire coming your way.
Yep, down smash to F smash. It just works so well as long as you get that grounding hitbox.
It's gonna set your butt ablaze, man. Okay, there we go, DM.
I think it just works every time.
And the thing is, it's hard for him to try to start getting these conversions off of it, too, because you see Gon's starting to do the up B using the jump. You know, the fire.
Ooh.
There we go.
Okay, good up tilt.
Very rare appearance of that move.
It is so jarring.
Yeah. Another parry coming out.
I don't feel the oof of a parry as often as your Game & Watch does it. Because it doesn't have eyes, so like, I can't tell.
They don't turn yellow.
I wish he turned yellow.
His entire soul.
Yeah.
There we go. Forward smash sends him off the stage again. Thunderstorm is a brewing.
Catching him again with the up airs. DM just going to retreat back to stage, center stage right now. Yeah, it looks like he's going to have to start adapting to the fact that Gons is probably going to meet the up be out of any sort of hit. Maybe start going for more of the follow-ups. Oh, from the top rope.
Go. Gaunt is cheering. He's gone trying to go for the chef as well. So many quick attacks. That's the one thing I can just comment about with DM. He's just always doing it to try to get away. I'm sure for a lot of players, this would be super annoying to deal with, but Gonzalez has an answer. He has a key, if you will, to the
Keys
door.
University, baby.
Yeah.
So good stuff there from Gaunt as he has a 2-3 to stock the one lead over DM right now. And DM, again, it looks like he's got a hit of really some like serious case of the autopilot since the other throw. Gets the job done. You see him, he's going for the quick attacks to kind of break zone, starts him on Gons, and then he just does that. I don't really think he's been able to find an answer to, you know, what to do when Gons is up, he's out of his stuff.
Yeah, oh, gets him the last bit of that down air hitbox. And that's the thing about Game & Watch, right, is he does have that up B, just immediately do, just if he feels threatened in the least bit, he just go for it, there's invincibility on
it.
But honestly, if he just keeps landing those hammers, man, he's just gonna keep grounding and get the forward smash right afterwards. That's all you need.
Is Mr. Game & Watch about to punch his ticket to Grand Finals?
Probably. I mean, I see it happening. I wouldn't be shocked.
Neither would I, honestly. But
Gons is putting in a lot of work. You know, he's up 2-1 against your boy. DM looking for this answer with Pikachu.
And DM looks like he is just not fazed by what's going on right now. He knows, it's like, okay, he's got to play a little bit more solid. Maybe start adapting to the fact that God's just going to autopilot up B out of any time I touch him. Maybe start just, you know, going for these options and then just waiting for the follow-up. Juggling.
Yeah. I mean, it's tough because he's so slippery in the air. Like, when you see Mr. Gaiman watch up there because he has the Pokemon Trainer.
Training in one Pokemon for three.
Yeah. I mean, you're supposed to have six Pokemon in your arsenal, you know. Here comes the other three. All he needs now is Mewtwo and Lucario, and he's good to go. Incineroar, never heard of him.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go. Back here. Immediately goes for the up B. He had to push that because, or else, like, Gons would have had him off stage completely with that back air.
Yeah, so right now, we'll take a steady diet of Squirtle for the time being. But now, gonna get the transition over to Ivysaur.
Now, with Ivysaur, you're gonna get a lot of damage off those grabs because it gives him a very easy confirm into that Vine Whip afterwards. Also, the Razor Leaf, he gets so much mileage off of them, right? Because not only is it a projectile, but he can easily get the up B immediately following afterwards.
Yep, without a doubt, man.
And it's super safe to do it from as long as you're like from a distance, right? If you're too close to that projectile, Gons can easily get that punish.
Oh, yeah, without a doubt. And I feel like Game Watch is so slippery through the air, like you were saying. I think he's going to be able to really hit the blind spots on a lot of Pokemon trainers' moves better than other characters probably could. See DM just kind of bailing on Ivysaur. He's got through three Pokemon. No stocks to show for it yet.
Yeah, he scoops him up with the up smash. Tries to go for it a second time, but Gons trying to chase this landing. I like that mix-up. Not going to be able to land on the top platform. You know if you would have connected it up there, that would have been the stock.
Oh, yeah, without a doubt. Just a little bit too far to the left. See ya!
Another down smash,
right
another forward smash.
So good, man. There you go.
All I had to do, just get right behind him, get the grab, get the back throw, and now, you know, the local region cheering for their boy DM. What? The first hit, you hear that little love tap that happened from that back air, or that forward air, rather?
Feels bad, man.
Yeah. Okay. Back to center stage, just holding onto that shield for as long as possible.
Mr. Game Watch's forward air is so weird.
It's because it's like a projectile, because it comes down. It's really, it's a nuisance.
And
to
if you
deal
hit
with.
It, like, doesn't have a hitbox on it. So,
yeah.
Like, it's very strange. But nonetheless, Gons is putting the work in on Squirtle right now. So now DM forced to recover again. Switching to Ivysaur is probably going to be the power play to help get himself back in this game damage wise.
So open for the neutral get up. Yeah, the down smash charging a little bit too soon allowed DM to be able to react to the option. And dead again. He's her trainer man in the background.
Ivysaur.
He's like, no.
Yeah, Ivysaur. Trainer putting his hand in his head. He is not pleased right now. Gons.
One stock away from moving on into Grands, man. Can he pull it off? Nair at a good shot, a shield option. Four Razor Leafs coming out. There we go. Gets the grab. DM struggling to find his way back down to the ground.
No.
An obstacle for Charizard to give himself some extra weight.
Yeah, but at the same time, you don't want to switch to Charizard mid-combo, especially when you know, Game Watch can kind of keep you in the air for a while.
Trying to abuse that invincibility upon the switch of Pokemon, I guess.
Very true.
Forward air. Gets the fire up B. Obstacle for the Flare Blitz. Misses the punish.
Mr. Game Watch sucks.
I mean, are you sure, dog?
Absolutely not.
Okay. Oh, God. Flare Blitz puts him in a terrible spot. Gets the key. Gets the kill. Gons sitting in grand finals representing New Jersey proudly. Here at Smash W 2019.
That could have been the good start that DM was looking for, but just a little bit too far off to the left for that to work. And right in the mouth. Down smash. Let's see Gons with a little fist bump. He is super pumped about this. Because there's a lot of money online for this right now. So,
yeah.
On Gons, baby. We continue to move on here.
On Gons. DM just could not find an answer, so he's taking a trip down to Losers Finals. But let's take a spin to Losers Semis. We've got some familiar faces coming up over here. I see Ling Ling sitting down.
Yes, sir.
Ling Ling, the peach extraordinaire
going
from
up
Connecticut.
Against, Sauce.
Sauce the boss. He's
what kind of a spin
here.
Are we going to take? Are we taking like a tail spin?
Spin dash. I was thinking about spin dash, man. But yeah, that's what's going to happen here again. You know, Sauce, another player that, once more, I like to add on, that we don't expect to see in top eight, let alone top four. He's already here sitting in Loser Semis, fighting off against Ling Ling. Took out Dill earlier on in the bracket, you know, getting rid of New York.